Hi everyone, Grant K here for the Flame Premium Learning Channel. In this video, we take a look at the profiling functionality that will enable you to sculpt your 3D shapes in a variety of ways. Please note that everything I'm about to show you will be applicable to 3D text. 3D text and 3D shapes are both using the redesigned profiling functionality in Flame Premium 2015. And I'm sure you'll see the benefit straight away. I'm going to start off in action with a flat 3D shape. If you want to follow along, just create any 3D shape you want. Now, since a 3D shape is a proper 3D object, it will have a front face and a back face. This has an influence on the way the 3D shape's profile is extruded and manipulated. So to make this very clear, take the 3D shape and rotate it on its x-axis to minus 90. Going back to the 3D shape basics menu, I'll extrude the 3D shape quite a bit. If you haven't already done so, go to the Action Node Preferences and turn shading on. So the extrusion looks fine, but I want you to have a closer look at how the extrusion was actually created. This horizontal line in the center of the 3D shape is the 2D creation plane. This is where the extrusion is derived from. By having the extrusion set to center, the front and back face of the 3D shape will extrude out from the center of the 2D plane. Naturally, you can click on the drop-down menu and choose to only extrude the front face of the 3D shape. So from the 3D shape, the extrusion grows forward. Or you can switch to back. This grows the back face of the 3D shape backwards. And finally, you can choose a custom setting. This allows you to alter the ratio of how much the front face is extruded compared to the back face of the 3D shape. Now let's take a look at what you can now do once the profile has been extruded. I'll set my extrusion back to center. Next, I'll rotate my 3D shape to minus 45 degrees in the X rotation and turn off the icons with I. In the 3D shape menus, switch to the profile menu. In Flame Premium 2015, the profiling functionality has received a significant boost that affects 3D shapes and 3D text. In previous versions of the application, you only had beveling with a small graph. This has been increased to beveling, rotation, and scaling on the profile, as well as more controls for a more refined experience. With the bigger curve editor, it has been clearly defined what part of the curve will affect the front face, the center, and the back face of the extruded 3D shape. This is all tied in with the extrusion settings in the Basics menu. Now let's talk beveling. Beveling does not completely scale the geometry. As before, it erodes the geometry to round off the edges. You can shape the curve accordingly. The samples control the number of subdivisions in the geometry for non-flat curves. There is also an adaptive mode to optimize how the subdivisions are used throughout the geometry. You can adjust the tolerance slider to control the adaptive mode. Or you can disable the adaptive mode and set equal subdivisions across the entire 3D shape. So rotating the 3D model with the axis menu, you can see how the bevel is being applied to the extruded profile. Let's go back to the profile menu and choose scale. The curve editor now displays the scaling curve that will apply the scaling value to the profile. The curve behaves like all curves in the animation editor and can be altered in the same way. Using the tool's pull-down menu, switch to delete or press the D hotkey. I'll delete the middle control point on the curve. Switch back to select mode with M. So in addition to manipulating the control points, you also have control over curve interpolation. This is selection-based. You can press Ctrl and drag a box selection over the control points. Or you can just click the curve to select the entire curve and all the control points. You will find familiar curve interpolation modes just below the curve editor. I'll choose Linear for my example. I'll grab the control point for the back of the 3D shape and drag it downwards. You will notice that the adjustments change using three decimal places. To round the adjustments off to the nearest whole number, hold Alt and drag the control point. As an extra tip, if you want to adjust in increments of 10, hold Ctrl and Alt and drag the control point. So if I set my scale value to 50%, the back face is half the size of the front face. This is the same mathematical behavior as the scale percentage in the transformation controls. Now let's take a look at the rotation curve. I'll select the curve and switch it to linear. Holding Shift, I'll constrain the middle control point and move it right up to the front of the curve. Next, I'll drag the back face control point downwards. As an extra tip, you can zoom and pan the curve editor to get greater values if needed. So you can see the rotation being applied to the back portion of the 3D shape. One big point to mention is that all the three profile curves are animatable. Go to frame 1. Click the Set Key button. Now go to the last frame. I'll just drag the back control point upwards. Remember to click Set Key again to set a keyframe. Now scrub the time bar to see the animation. If needed, you might want to increase the subdivision samples. You just need to be aware that there is a non-specific threshold where the tessellation will struggle with extreme distortions, and this can result in artifacts, so just keep your eye on this. Finally, coming back to the point on animation, there is no visible animation channel for the animated profiles in the main animation editor. Unlike numerical sliders that can be mathematically mapped onto a curve, it's impossible to extract an animation channel for the profile curve. Therefore, you control your profile animation under the curve editor. Here you can set, reset, delete keyframes, as well as reset the selected profile curve. Now, up to this point, we've created 3D shapes that have originated in action. Coming soon, I'll show you how to import a vector illustration as 3D shapes and extrude it out in action. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Premium Learning Channel for future videos.